we know that for qualitative research, we try to investigate and analyze the phenomena of the students, of something that we try to see in a deeper view. At its core, qualitative research is marked by its exploratory nature. We just explore, we try to explore what's going on, what actually happens. One of the distinguishing features of qualitative research is its commitment to obtaining an in-depth understanding of the phenomena. We try, the purpose is to try to understand more deeper into the phenomena that we are going to investigate. For example, in the quantitative research, you ask the student, do you like to learn task-based language teaching? If they say yes, or if they say no, we just know how many students, how many percent of the students say yes, how many percent of the students say no. But we don't know, even though they say no, but what's wrong with it? Why don't they like it? Or if they say yes, what makes them to love task-based language teaching into the classroom, for example? So we try to explore deeper information. That's why we do qualitative research. Flexibility stands out as another character of qualitative research. Flexibility. When we do research, we are very flexible. Flexibility means that because the ideas of the people are changing and different person have different perspective. So we, the researcher, also need to be flexible in conducting qualitative research. Research designs are adaptable, allowing for adjustment as the study progresses. Emphasizing context is a fundamental aspect of qualitative research because we try to understand in-depth information about the participants, about their perception. So we also need to think about their culture, their context. If we understand those things, we might have a general view, a general picture of what's going to them. Researchers recognize that understanding a phenomenon requires considering a broader social, cultural, and historical context in which it unfolds. For example, one person say they dislike applied language, the task-based language teaching in their classroom. If we do quantitative research, we just understand, oh, they don't like. But if they don't like, we don't know why. But maybe if we ask them questions by interviewing, exploring more, talking to them, and then we, even though for interview, we say, do you like it? If they say, don't know, I don't like task-based language teaching, and then you need to, we are still don't actually get the real answer of if they don't, the answer no, but actually we don't understand the whole things of the no, right? So maybe if we talk more to understand their social, cultural learning, that maybe when they learn in some language school or in some at their high school, their context is in the situation that the teacher go visit the classroom, teach the lesson, and never ask the student to do any task. So maybe because of those kind of learning culture by the social context at that school, so these students do not like task-based language teaching because task-based language teaching require the student to participate in the classroom, to do more role in the classroom learning, focus on the student center. So in that situation, if we talk to the student, we will know why they like or they dislike task-based language teaching. So it means that for us, we can understand more about the phenomenon that the student did not like something, right? And here I give you one example of a case study. A case study is similar to qualitative research. The title is The Implementation of Task-Based Language Teaching in EFL Primary School Classroom, a case study in Vietnam by Bùi Trang, Trang Bùi. And you also see the Bùi Trang conducted this study in 2019. And you can see the link to the full research paper into this link. But here I provide the summarize for you, so can you have a look, read and understand this case studies. You can also look at my website and then you read easier.